Priming a primary IV tubing set. What we need to start with is the IV solution that we have ordered, the solution set or the tubing that we need, and then any connector that we might need to interface with the IV set that's in the hospital setting that we use. Once we have that done, I need to make sure that I've washed my hands prior to starting. I'm going to open my tubing. So usually on the back of the bag there's a little dotted line. You're going to open your tubing, and we need to do a couple things with it first. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take off the paper tape so that the tubing is free. This is going to go in our garbage pile so that I can unwind the tubing from itself. The next thing I need to do is I need to move the roller clamp up. The roller clamp is open or up like this, so it's able to be moved. And I'm going to move it up to the top of my tubing, and then I'm going to roller clamp it down like this. This is closed so that there will be no leaking of fluid until I'm ready. The other parts of the tubing that you'll notice, this is a blue slide clamp. A slide clamp means that you can slide it across and clamp the tubing like that. That's closed. This is open. There are injection ports where we can access to inject IV medications through, either by piggyback or by injection. And then there's an anti-reflux valve right here. What this does is this does not allow any medication or fluid that's injected below this point right here to ever go back up through the drip chamber and up into where the IV bag is going to be hanging, which is up here. This is the drip chamber, and that's the sterile spike. So now that we have our tubing ready to go and clamped, the last thing we need to do is decide if we need a connector to the IV that we have. In this case, we're going to use the Interlink system, so we do need this cannula, and when I open it, I need to make sure that I'm grabbing it by the cover, because this part is sterile right here. I need to keep it that way. I need to take off the blue cover that's sterile right here, and I'm going to put both sterile connectors together and lure lock it down so it's locked in place. Now that I have the tubing ready, the next thing I need to do is open my bag. When you open your IV bag, there's usually a rip tab, and you rip it down the side to get it out. Once I take it out, there's a few things I need to check for. One is the expiration date, so this is December of 2008, so it's fine. I need to make sure I have the correct solution. I need to make sure that the solution is clear, and that there's no precipitate, and that there's no leak, so I give it a little squeeze. Once I've done that, my solution is ready to go as well. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to prime my tubing. So I need to get ready by getting the IV bag usually in the non-dominant hand, and my spike in my dominant hand, and I'm going to pull off the sterile cover and the IV bag. I'm going to take off the sterile cover of the spike. I'm going to insert it into the IV bag. Next, I have to hang my IV bag up, and right now we're using a fake IV pole here. But I hang my IV up on an IV pole. The next thing I need to do is I need to fill my drip chamber at least halfway. I do this by squeezing and letting go about 2 times so that there's fluid in there, but I can still see it dripping. The next thing I need to do is I need to invert my ports. Now, when the tubing is hanging by itself, this is right side up. I need to invert these to upside down. I need to do that to all of the ports in the tubing set. Ours has 2, so I have both ports upside down. And the next thing I need to do is get control of my roller clamp. What I'm going to do is slowly open my roller clamp to allow the fluid to start to drip through the chamber and down into the tubing, and I'm going to watch it come down slowly and controlled is the weight that I need to do this. And I watch the fluid come into each of the ports and then out. And I can speed it up and slow it down by opening or closing my roller clamp. My goal is that I will get no air bubbles throughout any of the tubing. And so the way I do that is to make sure that I go slow and controlled to make sure that I prevent that from happening. Now, when I get close to the bottom here, I get through that last port. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to watch it come all the way to the end. And my goal is to get the solution to the tip of the cap without dripping all over. So once I have that, I close my roller clamp and I check one last time from the drip chamber down all the way to my patient very quickly just to make sure that there's no air bubbles in the tubing. And I don't see any air bubbles in my tubing. If you do see air bubbles, the one thing that you can make sure that you know is that you may have up to 1 inch of an air bubble in the tubing as a whole. The goal is to get 0. If we have more than 1 inch, it poses a risk for our patients with air emboli, and that's why we worry about that. Once we have this ready to go, I'm now ready to transition to getting it to my patient. But for this, this is the end of this, which is priming an IV bag.